Hello guys, this is Legionnaire94 and I'm gonna make a video about some tips and tricks I've learned in my HeadBall 2 experience, to be honest. Those tips and tricks will help you to improve your as a player and improve your character. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about what's the most important thing in this game. The most important thing in this game are the diamonds. The diamonds, because you can buy this with them. Always buy exclusive card packs and super character packs, because they give you legendary cards and you want the legendary cards. Never spend diamonds on something else. Don't buy character packs, don't buy powers, don't buy premium scratchers, and don't buy infinite ticket, double XP or double points. You don't want to buy those because you need diamonds to buy those exclusive character pack and super character pack. As you can see, I have some character packs over some legendary characters over here. A few of them. Those are the most powerful in the game. As you can see, this rare, level 30 rare, it has power 55.5, and this level 10 legendary has 50 power. It's the strongest, but still, level 10 legendary, 50 power. Almost like the level 30 rare. Okay. The second thing I want to talk about are the accessories. Never forget to buy accessories, because they give you big chunks of power. As you can see, if I remove glasses and the tail, my character will have 71 power. If I equip them, he has 76.5. That means 5.5 power only in two items. It's enormous. I don't know, it's gigantic. Okay, always try to buy these costume packs when you are new in the game. Don't buy powers, don't buy scratchers, only costume packs, because they give you a nice boost of power. Good. Before we go to the third thing, I want to tell you where to get diamonds. Well, you can buy them, but I don't recommend. I spent only $10 in this game. You can get them from, of course, if you want to appreciate the developers and the staff of the game, you can show your gratitude by supporting their work and their labor, buying some diamonds and, you know, giving them some money to evolve the game. But you can get them from career, as you can see, diamonds. I just got them at level, 117. Okay, you can get diamonds from scratchers, right? Low rate, low drop chance, but still. And you can get diamonds from weekend tournaments and stuff like that. The first thing I wanna talk about are the leagues. Important things in this game, because they give you big prizes. As you can see, I'm the first in the top one league, and they give me 500 diamonds if I win it. And how do I do to make some fast points and don't play like a maniac this game? Well, I usually wake up in the morning and activate this triple points boost. 30 minutes, I go and play a match, I win it, I get 9 points, I can double them by watching an ad. Then exit the game, reopening it, playing another match, and I can double again by watching an ad my points. And by doing this 5 times, because you can double by watching an ad 5 times, and then you have a cooldown of 7 hours. By doing this five times, you have 90 points. That means almost 200 per day. That means 1,400 a week, which is a decent amount of points with which you can win all the leagues almost. Good, let's collect this prize. It's a bonus, action for this video. It wasn't supposed to happen now. Let's see what it gives me. Chieftain, nice. I have this in duplicates. But still, I have 13 from the chieftain. It's nice. Good. Now, in the second part of this video, I want to talk about the tricks that will help you make that will help you become a better player. I have 5 tricks. First of all, I want to tell you to start the game with a low kick. When the match starts, try to low kick because the vast majority of the opponents will jump. The second trick is never pass the midfield line. Always focus on your defense, because if you pass the midfield line, you will be dangerously close to your opponent and he would have the chance to shot a fire of with the ball above your head, and you won't have the reaction time to counterattack it. The third thing is always keep a certain distance. Why? Because let's imagine that your opponent is firing a shot. If you have a certain distance from him, you'll have the time to react. And besides this, if you have the time and you react good and you fire a shot back, he won't have time to land and then jump again to counterattack your attack. Good. The fourth thing is always try to alternate your kicks. Don't go high kick, high kick, high kick, high kick, because it's very predictable. You know, you have to surprise your opponent. You have to go, I don't know, low kick, high kick, high kick, low kick, high kick, low kick, you know, something like this. And the last one is the most important I've learned in this game. It's the bot scheme named. I named it like this. I learned this from the bots from this HeadBall 2. You know, there are lots of bots. It's basically you walk with the ball at your feet, and when you collide in your opponent, the ball will fly in the air, then just jump and kick. And that's a certain goal. Your opponent will have no chance for counterattacking it. Okay, now let's play a game. Hopefully I'll show you those. And I won't get a bot, because that would suck. Okay, it's a nice opponent, 56 power. It's good. Let's try to low kick first, okay? Low kick. It didn't work. But anyway, always try to do that. Okay, now let's try some alternate attacks. High kick, low kick, high kick, low kick, low kick again. Okay. Okay. Puck, low kick, high kick, sorry. Okay, I'm bad. Okay, now let's try the bot scheme. Look, just walk and you reach him, jump, bam. You know? Of course I failed, but it happens. See, now I kept a certain distance and he didn't have time to react at me. Okay, I tried the bot scheme, it didn't work. Keep the distance, always keep the distance. Okay, I was bad at this part of the game. Okay, the bot scheme. Oh. Okay, I failed again. Hopefully the third time is with luck. The third time is no. It didn't work. Okay, it seems that this guy is bad too. But he's still good. I mean, I have bigger power than him. Okay, the bot skin. Oh, not good. Okay, now we met the bot skin again. See, that was the bot skin. I finally managed to do it. Never pass the midfield. You can pass now because the big gold is activated, but never pass this. Look, certain distance, I'm keeping it. And now he will attack. And the... come on. Okay, I'm gonna use the... Okay, I need extra time. No problem, we will practice the tricks more. Bot scheme. Okay, it didn't work again. It's a hard scheme, you know. I don't manage to do it all the time. Sorry for being retarded. Okay. Come on, dude. Okay, seems like I have to play a little more aggressive now. So let's play. Good. Okay, now okay, he managed to trick me this time. So never pass the midline. Always try to alternate your shots. Good. Bam. Try to trick him. Oh, he's scared. Okay. So guys, you've seen the rules. Try a low kick in the start. Never pass the midfield. Use a certain distance because you need some react time. Alternate your kicks. Low kick, high kick, low kick, high kick. Try to practice the bot scheme a lot because it's so effective. And of course you say now, oh my god, you beat this guy so hard. I mean, he's so low in power. But trust me, I just showed this I just wanted to show you how to use the tricks. And still, he was a good player. We should admit that. Okay, guys, this was all. If you want to join my team, this is my team. It's a nice environment. We are friendly people. We can help with advices and stuff like that. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If that liked the video, hit the subscribe button, I don't know. And if you have some questions, just leave them in the comment section below. And if there are interesting questions, I'll try to even make a video about them. Yeah, sure, why not? Okay, thanks guys, have a nice day and good luck.